Thank you, Mr. Chairman and members. There are many people here tonight to give you their stories. We've heard many of these stories by going to meetings with seniors and disabled people. And I just want to give you some data. So, and the data that I'm giving you is from RIPTA. That they indicate that 17,700 low-income disabled and about 7,000 low-income seniors use these passes. Now, they use them for many to get to many things. The only thing that Medicaid covers is trips to licensed medical providers. It doesn't cover non-medical support groups like AA, other social services, food shopping, food pantries, employment, education, religious, family, and social activities. A number of disabled people ride the bus to get to employment. The average number of one-way trips that seniors take are, this is RIPTA data, 31 a month. So that comes out to $15.50 a month on average. Some more than that. Disabled persons average 39 one-way trips a month. That's almost $20 a month. This bill would repeal the legislation that you enacted last year, which actually is permissive that RIPTA could go to a dollar. The legislation does not keep it at 50 cents. RIPTA board voted to implement a 50 cent fee, but they could go to, they could double that to a dollar. The RIPTA's guesstimate of what, how much money this would generate is just that. They estimated that 60% of the people, the last estimate we heard from them, 60% of the people would pay the 50 cents. Applying that to numbers, 7,000 disabled people and 2,800 seniors would not be able to afford. This is RIPTA's, but it's a guess. It could be even less money that it would generate. What they're saying is that this is the 1.7 million is what they estimate they additional revenue that they would raise. Finally, we are not an outlier. That statement has been made. Metro areas, Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, other parts of Pennsylvania, Chicago, Illinois area, Houston, Texas, San Francisco, and a number of smaller cities offer free bus passes to seniors, and in some of them, they offer some passes to disabled persons as well. So these are very poor people. 87% of the people who use this, their income is below, they offered Medicaid as their proof of eligibility. So that means for individuals, their income is below $16,000, and for couples, their income is below $21,000. And we heard plenty of people say that that they cannot afford the 50 cents. And we asked them that question. We said, well, what about it? How many of you now could afford this? And the, and as you can see, they use these for a number of different trips, not just Medicaid will pay to get them to a doctor. We've got a system with LogistiCare that has a lot of problems. I think you may have heard about that. So please listen to these stories, and please understand we are talking about thousands of very, very vulnerable people. And the last thing, which I think you've heard from me in another context, is there's a growing band of evidence that the single greatest threat to longevity for seniors and to their health is isolation. The single, more than Alzheimer's, more than other types of chronic illness, isolation is bad for people's health. That was also quoted in the article in the ProJo about what happens when people can no longer drive. If you read that a couple of weeks ago, when people stop driving, it's bad for their health as well. It's well documented. So this is a serious matter, and I urge you to reconsider and to some degree find some additional money for RIPTA if you can. We acknowledge that. But if to raise 1.7 million, which is a guess, it could be less, and to injure a lot of people is not a good deal. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.